Hello friends, welcome back to the Python programming session. In the earlier session, we had looked into the for loop and the while loop in repetitive control structure. And in today's session, let's look into the nested for and nested while loops in the repetitive control structure. So what do you mean by nested for? Nested for is just like a nested if, one if within an if. So this is nothing but one for loop within another for loop. And nested while is nothing but one while loop within which there is another while loop. So now let's look into some of the code examples of how nested for work in Python. So code examples. For nested for. So let's take two lists and give a loop, for loop, two for loops and see what the result would be. So I have two lists. One is the color equal to red, blue, green. So I am having three colors in one particular list. And the name of the list is called as color, which is the identifier. This is the assignment operator and square brackets includes a list. So let me have one more list, which is the shape. Then I give circle, square, rectangle. So basically I am having two lists over here, one is the color and one is the shape. And now let's work on the nested for loop. So I say for iterating variable, I is my iterating variable, for I in sequence. Sequence in this case is a list. So I say color, for I in color is my iterating value, and this is the sequence and this is the colon. So this is the syntax for the for loop, for I in color. Then I give another nested for loop. Since it is a part of the first for loop, it has to be indented by quote spaces. For J in shape. So iterating value and then a sequence. So now for this for loop, I am having one print statement. Print I comma j. So this is how. And then the sequential flow of statements continue, wherein I can say print end of program. So this statement is within this for loop, so it has to be indented. And again this statement is within the inner loop, so again it has to be indented. And these two statements are part of the first for loop. So how does it work over here and what would be the output? So let's see how the nested for loops work in Python. So for every value of I, the j value iterates over the entire contents of the list. And every value, so for red, so for I in color, so first it will take red. So I is red. For j in shape, so for j in shape, it is circle. Print I comma j. So initially I would be red and j would be circle. So it will print red circle on the console. Now the second inner loop increments. It becomes square, but I would be still red. So print I comma j now prints red and then square. Similarly, the j loop has not yet ended. So I would still be red and j would have the value rectangle. So it will print red rectangle. So now the J value has ended. So it will go to the outer for loop, and the outer for loop it takes the next value, that is blue, and J will again perform the same iterations for the shape list. So first it will be blue, and then circle, blue square, blue rectangle. So it will be blue circle, blue square, and then blue rectangle. So this is how it works. And now the jth loop has got ended. After the rectangle there is no other item, so it goes to the outer for loop and it takes the green value. So for green again it will repeat circle, green square, and then green rectangle. And so the value green circle, green square, green rectangle gets printed on the console. So when I say print I comma y, it will print first red circle, red square, red rectangle, then blue circle, blue square, blue rectangle, then green circle, green square, green rectangle. So for every item of the outer loop, the inner loop performs the full complete iterations, and for the next value again it will perform the same, iterate over the same items, and for the next it will iterate over the same items. So our output would be like this on the console. And then I'm having the sequential flow of control. So end of program gets printed. PGM. So this gets printed. So this is how the nested for loop works in Python. Hope so, friends, this is clear for you, the nested for loop. And the sequence which we have used here is nothing but a list. Now let's take one more example in which our sequence is a range. So for this I take two for loops, that is nested for loop. So initially for I in range 1, 6 and then colon. Then I have one more for loop for J in range I. Then I say print star comma end equal to space. Then I say print and just give the print command. So how does this particular for loop work in Python? So range means it takes from 1 till n minus 1. So it will range, I ranges from 1 to 5. So my I ranges from 1, 2, 3, 4 and then 5. And for every value of I, J ranges from to the value of I. So initially I would have the value 1. So here in jth loop, the range is replaced by 1. So since the value is 1 initially, it will range n to n minus 1, that is it becomes 0. So it will range from 0, 1, 2, 3 and then 4. So my I value ranges from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and the jth value ranges from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So friends, this is quite tricky. Let's see how it works. Initially my I is 1. So J in range of 1, 1 minus 1, that is n minus 1, 1 minus 1 becomes 0. Print the star. So for the 0th value, for I equal to 1 and J equal to 0, it will enter the loop and it will print star. So it will print star once. What does end equal to space do? For every iteration, it will give a space and it will start printing stars. And what does print do? It comes to the next line. So my jth loop has ended. It has printed only for the zeroth value and now it has ended. So it will come to the this print statement and it will go to the next line. Next line is this line. And it will perform the fourth loop and it will increment I to 2. So I becomes 2. For j in range of I. So I now is equal to 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. So it will print 2 stars, one for the 0th value and one for the 1th value. It will give a space. End equal to space means it will give a space and it will print the second value. Now our jth loop has ended. So it will come to the print statement. The cursor moves to the third line. Now it will go back to the for loop and check what is the value of I now. It is 3. So 3, j becomes, jth value becomes 3 minus 1 equal to 2. So it is 0, 1, 2. So for every value of I, j increments with 0, 1 and 2. So, it will print the asterisk 3 times. 1, 2 and then 3. And now it comes to the print statement. It will come to the new line. Now, I value will become 4. And j will range from 0 to 3. Because n minus 1, 4 minus 1 is 3. So, it will range from 0 to 3. That is 4 stars would get printed. And now it prints, comes to the new line. So that is the 5th line. And I will have the value 5. And j will have value 1, 0 to n minus 1. That is 4. 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So it will print the asterisk 5 times. And then 5. So this is what gets printed on the console when you execute this particular Python program. So the asterisks in this format gets printed. The pattern in this format gets printed for this particular code. Hope so friends, this is clear for you. Now let's move on to the nested while loop. Code examples for nested while. So for this nested while, let me take my I, let us print a multiplication table wherein we multiply the numbers and print the multiplication table. For this I have two while loops. So initially I am having my I equal to 1 while I less than or equal to 3 colon. So this is the condition and this is the colon. This is the syntax for the while loop. While I less than or equal to 3, then it enters the loop. There I am saying j equal to 1. And then while j less than or equal to 10, then I say print I into j, that is multiply I with j, comma end equal to space. Then I increment j plus equal to 1. So j equal to j plus 1. Now for then I increment I plus equal to 1. And then I say print. So friends, how does this particular code work in Python? So initially I is 1. So it checks the while condition while I less than or equal to 3. Yes, I is less than 3. Then it will assign j to 1. Then it will check while j less than or equal to 10. Yes, j is also less than or equal to 10. Then it prints I into j. I is 1, j is 1, 1 into 1 is nothing but 1. So 1 gets printed on the console. For every value of I, j iterates till 10. So now for the same value of I, that is 1, now j becomes j plus 1. So it becomes 2. So it becomes 1 into 2. So 1 into 2. The value is 2. So it will print 2. And then it, since we have given n equal to space, it will give a space. It won't come to the new line. In the same line with the space, it will print 2. Now my I is still 1 because the jth ending value is not yet reached. So I is still 1 into 3, the next value. So it becomes 3. Now j becomes 4. So 1 into 4 is 4. Then 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. When it reaches the 10th position, j, when you increment j to 1, it becomes 11. It will check for the while condition j less than or equal to 10. No, the condition has failed. So it comes out of the while loop and it executes this value, that is I is equal to I plus 1. So in this case I was 1 initially, it becomes 2. Then it will say print. So it comes, the cursor will not point here, it will come to the new line. Then again it will come over here and check if 2 is less than or equal to 3. Yes, 2 is less than or equal to 3, less than 3. So again it will reinitialize I j to 1. And j will range till, it will check if j is less than or equal to 10. Now my I value becomes 2. And j, again it is starting from 1. So 2 into 1 is nothing but 2. Then j increments to 2. 2 into 2 is 4. Next j increments to 3. 2 into 3 is 6. So on, it will go 2 into 4 is 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. So it completes till 10. Now my j value gets incremented to 11. So it will check, it fails, the condition fails. So it comes out of the loop and performs I equal to I plus 1. I was 2. So I becomes 3 now. And it will go to the while loop, outer while loop, and check if I is less than or equal to 3. Yes, it is equal to 3. So it again initializes j to 1 and the jth loop will go from 1 to 10. So I is 3, 3 into j, j initially is 1, 3 into 1 is 1, then j becomes 2, 3 into 2 is 6, 3 into 3 is 9, 3 into 4 is 12, 3 5s are 15, 3 6 are 18, 3 7s are 21, 3 8s are 24, 3 9s are 27, 3 10s are 30. Okay, now it prints and j becomes 11, it will come out and it will increment I to 4. Now it will check for the while condition, I less than or equal to 3. I is 4, which is greater than 3. So it comes out of the while loop. And then whatever statements are there in the sequential order, it gets executed. So this is the multiplication table which it has executed. Now if you want to print the multiplication table till 10, that is 4, 5, 6, table of 4, 5, 6, then you can just change the value over here, I equal to less than or equal to 10. Or whatever value you want, you can give, specify, and j will be ranging from it will go from 1 to 10. So you can have any number of multiplication table as you want. This is just a simple example of knowing how the nested while works in Python. Hope so, friends, this is clear for you. The nested for loop and the nested while loop. In the for loop, we saw with the sequence equal to list and the sequence equal to range. In the for loop, in the while loop, we saw with the range, with the sequence equal to range. Hope so, friends. This is clear for you. If you have any doubts, please do reach to me out in the comment section. If you like my video, click on the like button and please do subscribe to get notifications of my new videos. Till then, see you. Bye bye.